One of the pressing questions that I've come to the symposium with is that capital has always been thought of in terms of financial capital. And I think especially in our parts of the world, in Asia, in the subcontinent, mm-hmm. I think capital has always been seen as a means for the powerful to gather more power. Mm-hmm. Even within our countries dealing with international financial institutions, we see that capital is a means for the country to take on enormous loans on some really strange conditions. Mm-hmm. And that really sort of changed the country and its people to certain standards and certain conceptions of capital only in its financial terms. I want to challenge the leaders of today to think about capital in terms of human capital, of social capital, and what it takes for especially international financial institutions to start to think along those lines, and what it means for them to stop thinking about profit in the long term and to start thinking about social responsibility in the long term. That's my question.
Well, for me, it's not just about financial capital. Capital is very holistic, but capital has to be seen in relationship to entrepreneurs. For me, purpose results from the combination of entrepreneurial ideas, drive, and energy that are leveraged by capital. And of course, it's not only financial capital, it's also resources, it's know-how, it's capabilities, it's human capital. For me, profit and purpose are not contradictions. There are a lot of profitable ideas and ambitions and entrepreneurial projects that can be pursued with profit. So in my book, it's not about trading profit off against purpose, but it's to look purposeful for solving problems that are important for society in a way that attracts capital and that can achieve then profit that makes sure that also those that provide the capital are getting their benefits from it. It's not a trade-off, it's a combination.